things since living was gold rings. Fuck a piece of the pie, nigga, give me the whole thing. I done seen death, seen lust, seen more, feed more fiends, the more fiends than you ever seen. This pain I deliver reflects in every word like a mirror. Bigger picture, try keep shit in perspective. Thumbs out, guns out, till my time runs out. Capitalistic driving force, got no remorse. But I feel shit catching up, time wrapping up. Shine had enough, still I can't have enough. Something by the engine roaring, soaring, wind in my face. Top down, take me to another place. Diamonds and Mac-10s.
What is up, guys? Welcome to another episode of Maximilian Must Know. This is another best of 2013 list, and I think this is an original. I think I might be the first person to do this. I could be wrong. There might be others. But what we're going to do is I'm going to tell you, you know, I got about 190 cents last year, but I got about 500 to 600 samples of decants. And I want to go through the top 10 things I enjoy that I haven't gotten a full bottle of yet that I plan on getting a full bottle of, hopefully, in 2013. I think that would just be interesting, and I don't think it's been done that much before, so I figured, why not? So here are the top 10 things I sampled that I think are bottle-worthy, and they're on my short list to get full bottles of. So I'm going to do two honorable mentions. The first honorable mention, I'm going to try to get these to focus. If they can't, they can't. This is a Floris scent, and it actually doesn't have the name on this one. Can we focus or no? Yes. This is a Floris of London scent from their private collection, and this is called Mahan Leather. And it's a really interesting leather scent. I've never smelled a leather scent like this. It almost... Most leather scents to me smell like black leather. This sort of smells like brown leather. It's $180 retail. It's not cheap, and I think it's a really interesting niche scent, and I really can't wait to get a bottle of Mahan Leather in 2014. The other one I plan on getting a bottle of 2014, another honorable mention, the second honorable mention is this guy. I have a pretty big decant of this. This is Parfum MDCI's Invasion Barbar. And I got a pretty big decant of this from the owner of the company, actually. He sent me a few different decants because of my show. I really like Claude. He's a great guy. And I fell in love with this as soon as I sniffed it. This was love at first sniff. Some people say it smells like a Band-Aid. Some people say it's not that special. To me, it's special. I think it's absolutely outrageous. I think it's a classic fougère. Really, really nice male signature scent, and I think I'll be getting a bottle of this in 2014, probably without the bust on the top, because that'll save me $250. Now, number 10, guys, I don't have a sample of because I used it all. But by the time you see this video, it's very possible I will own a bottle of this, because I plan on getting one for my birthday next week, and it is Acqua de Parma's Colonia Oud. I just think that's a tremendous oud scent. If you watch my earlier sample shopping videos, I looked at that scent and I didn't like it. But I was at Bergdorf Goodman about 6 months ago, and the woman said, let me just spray you something and you tell me what you think. I'm not going to tell you what it is. She did. I liked it. It was ADP oud. Made me come back to it, and I really like it now. I think it's an oud scent you could wear 12 months out of the year, and I think it's very clean and crisp, sort of like Tom Ford's Oud Wood. I think it's a great oud scent. So number 10 is ADP oud. Number 9 is a Bond number 9 scent, one that people don't go nuts about. This is Fire Island, and this smells a lot to me like suntan lotion. That's what this really is. It is primarily a suntan lotion scent. But it smells like really expensive suntan lotion. It's very different. It's very different than Virgin Island water, which a lot of people say smells like suntan lotion too. There's no coconut here. It smells like really expensive suntan lotion they would use vacationing in like Saint-Tropez. I think it's beautiful. I plan to get it for the warm months ahead. Number 8 is a Histoire de Parfum release. I have barely any of this left. I like it that much. This is Ambrarum by Histoire de Parfum from their Edition Rare collection with Petroleum and Rosum. I haven't smelled Petroleum yet, but I have smelled this, and I am in love with this oud, leathery, dirty scent. I think it is absolutely fantastic, and I plan on getting a full bottle of this as well in 2014. Number 7, we're on oud. This is another one that by the time you watch this, I probably am going to have a full bottle of this because I've already ordered it. This is Creed's Royal Oud. I know that some people are going to say that this isn't a real oud scent. And they may be right. I mean, I get a little bit of oud out of it. I think it should probably be called Royal Spice, like a lot of other people have said. But I think it's a great Creed scent. It's one of my Creed favorites. And I already have a bottle ordered, so not having this will change very shortly. Number 6 is another Creed one. This one's a little bit harder to get my hands on, so I don't know whether I'm going to get it or not. This is Windsor. This was sent to me from Adriana by Decant Shop. I didn't fall in love with this when I did it on the show, but that lime and that gin and that pine, oh my god. I don't think it's worth the money, so I don't know if I'm going to be able to get myself a full bottle of this in 2014. I'd like to. If it's reasonable, maybe I'll just get a big decant because it's a great, great scent. Fortunately, it doesn't last that long on my skin, which is why I don't think it's really worth the money, but we'll see. Number 5 is a Tom Ford fragrance, not from their Privé line. Actually, this is from their signature release, and this is, can I get this to focus here? This is Black Orchid, and I love this stuff, man. It's expensive for this designer side of fragrances, but oh man, is that good. I really like that. It's a unisex, but it really is unisex. Either gender could pull this off. It's a really nice dark floral scent, and to me, it's absolutely gorgeous. Number 4 is a scent from Byredo. This is probably going to be the first Byredo fragrance that I buy. And this one is called Pulp. And I know you guys probably know this. Mark put it on a top list of his recently. Byredo's been blowing up in FragComp. And this smells like, it's one of the most powerful fruit scents I've ever smelled in my life. But it's not citrus. It's almost like a basket of tropical fruits just about to rot. And not rotting, but just about to turn bad. So it's really intense and pungent, and it's a perfect scent as far as I'm concerned for warmer weather. Number 3 is another fragrance I plan on getting within the next 2 months. Blown away by this. Blown right the fuck away. This is Imaginary Authors Falling into the Sea. This is another tropical fragrance with a beautiful lychee note. Josh is a genius, and he knocked the ball out of the park with Falling into the Sea. I'm going to wind up owning 4 scents for Imaginary Authors. I already have Memories of a Trespasser. This is next. Then The Soft Lawn, then Cape Heartache. But this is my second favorite from the Imaginary Authors line, Falling into the Sea. We've got 2 more left. Let's just do it. Number 2, I still have some of this left, but I transferred it into an atomizer. I got this when I bought my bottle of Oud Wood. This is Tuscan Leather. Now, you're not going to focus your fucking iPhone? No, I guess not. All right, it is what it is. I guess it's because it's gold. Tom Ford Tuscan Leather. Now, this could have been interchanged with Black Saffron by Byredo. If all things were equal, I'd probably prefer Tuscan Leather. But because of the huge price disparity, I think I'll probably wind up buying Black Saffron. It's $100 cheaper. I haven't tried Golden Boy by Duetto, but I'd like to. Hopefully I'll be able to get a sample of that sometime. But man, is Tuscan Leather good. Smells like cocaine, so I've heard. I'm not going to comment on that, man. Not going to be indicting myself. But it's just a beautiful smell regardless. It smells like leather. It's dark. It's beautiful. There's not much out there better than Tom Ford's Tuscan Leather. And number 1, the one that I sampled this year that really blew me away and I didn't expect it to, I went to the Hermes store to get Amber Nargis. And I walked out with Amber Nargis. And there was no way there was anything else that I could smell from the line that would maybe make me think I shouldn't have gotten Amber Nargis first. And I still stick to that, I think. But what's made me sort of question it is this. This is Hermes's Vetiver Tonka from the Hermesens line. A stunning, stunning vetiver scent with a nutty, praline, hazelnut note. And so you've got this sort of earthy vetiver with that sweetness. It is outrageous. It makes for a very unique and I think just all around great fragrance. Vetiver Tonka by Hermes. So that has been this list, guys. We're doing 2 more of these, just so you know. And they're the 2 that I'm really looking forward to doing. I'm so excited to do these 2. The first one is going to be the top 10 designer fragrances that I bought in 2013. And I bought about 150, 130 designer fragrances. And the second one is going to be the top 10 niche fragrances that I bought in 2013. That's the one I think most people are looking for, most of you guys are looking forward to, and the one that I'm looking forward to most shooting and doing. Anyway, I want to thank you guys all so much for watching. There will be a fragrance review tomorrow. We will be doing a fragrance from the house of Parfumerie Generale. So hopefully you'll enjoy that. Thank you all so much for watching again. Please don't forget to hit like, comment, and subscribe.
Diamonds and Mac 10s. Tell a friend, yellow bottles, models, hollows till my very end. Catching up the guard quicker, high off the slicker. Niggas come to get you, better know they're coming. Diamonds and Mac 10s. Tell a friend, yellow bottles, models, hollows till my very end. Catching up the guard quicker, high off the slicker. Niggas come to